The Bright Side, your nutritional program dedicated to the understanding of the vast world of nutrition and nutritional supplementation. I'm your host, Pharmacist Ben, nutritional pharmacist from Boulder, Colorado. I use nutritional supplements where other healthcare practitioners use toxic pharmaceutical drugs and sometimes deadly medical procedures if you suspect that there are natural nutritional roads to your health and vitality and well-being and to addressing your health challenges, whatever they may be. But you don't know where to begin, you have come to the right place. As you listen to The Bright Side every day, you are more and more in control of your body, you are more and more knowledgeable, and you know you can overcome any health challenge. That is why we are here every day on The Bright Side, helping clear up the sometimes confusing world of nutrition and nutritional supplementation. Over the last 32 years of practicing pharmacy, I have seen drug-free recoveries from diabetes, hypertension, obesity, skin diseases like acne, psoriasis, eczema, rosacea, digestive ailments, autoimmune issues of all kinds. Recoveries that by the standards of modern medicine can only be called a miracle, but what is in the world of the body, what is in the world of biology, standard operating procedure. Because the human biological system is a healing system, it's a regenerating system, it is designed divinely to heal and renew itself on a moment-to-moment basis. And while some folks may call that healing, renewing, regenerating system a miracle, it really is just the way the body works. If you have questions about health, nutrition, prescription drugs, if you want to wean yourself off your meds and get on a good nutritional supplement program, we are your go-to source for all things health and nutrition. We love hearing from you. Give us a call at 844-236-6010. 844-236-6010. You can also call 866-735-2470 if you're interested in checking out the Longevity products or the Longevity business, 866-735-2470. Or you can sign up right off our websites, brightsideben.com, pharmacistben.com, and criticalhealthnews.com. You can purchase Longevity products, sign up to join the Bright Side Ben team for a one-time $25 fee, and you can check out our blogs, our blog articles, news stories, as well as videos that we have up. All good, solid, free nutrition and health information at brightsideben.com, pharmacistben.com, and criticalhealthnews.com. All right, our number today, 844-236-6010. If you have questions about anything that we're speaking about here today, or health, nutrition, or prescription drugs, we're talking about fats, which I absolutely love talking about. I find them to be the most fascinating of all the food groups. They're all fascinating, but something special about the fats. They're so misunderstood. I think that's why I'm fascinated with the fats. They're so misunderstood. Last program, we talked about the different kinds of distorted fats, the trans fats specifically. There's also the inter-esterified fats. That's another kind of tweaked fat. If you see vegetable oil on your processed food, you're pretty much going to be dealing with a trans fat or an inter-esterified fat, a processed fat of some kind. The problem with these kinds of processed fats is that the body will try to use them, especially for the formation of cell membranes. And that's really where you run into problems. I don't want to digress too much by talking about the cell membrane because it's super important, but we've talked about it a lot in the past. But just basically understand that all disease is cell disease, and the main determining factor for the health of the cell is the membrane. And that means it's a short jump from a messed up, tweaked, disrupted, distorted cell membrane, which happens when you, which you're going to end up with if you're ingesting a lot of trans fats and processed fats, if you're eating a lot of Twinkies, for example, if you're eating a lot of French fries, if you're using margarine, it's almost inevitable that you're going to have messed up cells. And from there, it's just a short jump to all chronic degenerative diseases, including cancer and heart disease, the two biggies, especially cancer and heart disease, the two biggies. But pretty much anything can happen just by ingestion of these processed fats or excessive ingestion of these processed fats, especially if you are deficient in the good fats. If you're deficient in the good fats, plus you're eating a lot of French fries, plus you're eating a lot of potato chips and margarine and all the other stuff that has the trans fats in it and the processed fats. Bakery goods are a real sneaky place where these trans fats live and these processed fats. We all know that if we eat French fries, we're eating a lot of greasy, nasty oils. But you don't always think about it when you're having a pastry or a croissant or anything, pretty much anything you can get at a bakery. Anyway, it's the cell membrane that is the determining factor of what's going to happen inside the cell. The cell membrane is the brain, membrane, B-R-A-I-N, That's how you can think of it. Read anything by Dr. Bruce Lipton. Read The Biology of Belief if you want more a more detailed understanding of it. It's absolutely mind-blowing what this membrane is. Anyway, the inside of the cell learns about the environment. The outside of a cell, that is the outside, communicates to the inside through the membrane. And all cells are responsive to their environment. I can think of no more important concept in the world of health than this. All cells are responsive to their environment. Cells are sitting in an ocean of electrolytes and water and hormones and vitamins and gases like oxygen and carbon dioxide and sugar. They're swimming in this environment. And this environment is communicating to the inside of the cell from the level of the membrane. That's why taking care of the membrane is so important and becoming more and more understood in the world of health, especially, particularly in the world of cancer. Cancer researchers are really honing in on the membrane. They're honing in on the membrane for a couple of reasons. First of all, they're honing in on the membrane because it's recognized that the membrane is really the key. As I was saying, it's the key communication point for the genetics. The genetics change based on what the membrane is telling it. So it's a key epigenetic element, the membrane. But even another reason why researchers are so fascinated, cancer researchers are so fascinated with the membrane, is because they're trying to figure out how to make the membrane more responsive to chemotherapy, to drugs. Yes, that's right. That's why they want to know about the membrane. They want to make the membrane more responsive to the drugs. Not we want to fix the membrane so that it's healthy and strong. We want to understand the membrane so we can kill the cell more effectively. But nonetheless, they are still studying the membrane. They're studying how to make that membrane more responsive to its environment. In the case of drug companies, they want to make it more responsive to the drug environment. But we can study the membrane and figure out how to make the membrane more responsive to the natural, normal cell environment. And guess what? Making sure you're ingesting the correct kind of fats is job number one. So the cell membrane is the brain of the cell. If it's damaged or dysfunctional in any way, as in when it's composed of trans fats or interesterified fats or any processed fats, you're going to have a messed up cell. And cancer in particular is initiated at this level. And this is why cancers of the prostate, cancers of the colon, cancers of the breast, which are among the three, I think they may be the three most common cancers, are so connected to the fat system. Breast cancer is a fatty issue. That's why people who have, when they have mastectomies, they'll take out the lymph being the transporter of fats. Focus on the fats. Breast cancer is an epidemic, right? One out of eight women is going to have it. It's a crazy epidemic. Same prostate cancer for that matter. Same with colon cancer for that matter. Focus on the fats. That means avoid the nasty fats as much as possible. I don't want to say it's the single most important thing you could do, but it's right up there when it comes to dietary and lifestyle strategies for keeping yourself healthy. Stay away from processed fats as best as possible. And even if it says 0% trans fat, don't be fooled, because there's other kinds of processed fats. There's no number, nobody even talks about the interesterified fats. So they all know about no trans fats and zero trans fats. All the marketers are touting their zero trans fats. But because people aren't aware of the other ways fats are processed, they can be fooled. So try to stick, if you're going to eat a fatty food, stick to coconut oil or butter or very, very, very well taken care of nutritional oils like Udo's Blend. Udo's Blend, by the way, the liquid, is a nutritional oil, and it's recommended that you use it like a teaspoon here and a teaspoon there, teaspoon a day or a couple teaspoons or a tablespoon a day, like to get your nutrition. But guess what? Udo's Blend is delicious. Mix it with salt and put on hard-boiled eggs. It's unbelievably tasty. Never cook your oils. Never heat your oils. Get your Udo's. Keep your Udo's in the fridge. Put a little bit on your hard-boiled eggs with salt or Tony Chachere's spice, whatever kind of spice you like. I like Tony Chachere's. Whatever it is. It is so tasty and so delicious. It has this nutty flavor to it. You can do a cucumber. Slice cucumbers up. Slice cucumbers and tomatoes. Mix a little Udo's Blend. Put some salt in there. Celtic sea salt. Some spices. You'll get your essential fatty acids. Taste delicious. And you'll also be helping activate the pigments in your eggs or in your veggies. All right, I'm Pharmacist Ben. 844-236-6010 is our number.
You've seen crazy...
are back on the bright side. Pharmacist Ben here, 844-236-6010 is our number, and we do have lots of lines open for you. In fact, all our lines are open for you at 844-236-6010, talking about these, about the nature of fats and relationship of fats to disease. Stay away from processed fats. If you see vegetable oil on your ingredient deck, and you should always be an ingredient deck reader, of course, that goes without saying. Ingredient deck reader on your skincare, ingredient deck reader on your ingested products, your food products. Learn about ingredients. If you see vegetable oil, or it doesn't even have to say a hydrogenated vegetable oil. Just if you see the word vegetable oil in a processed food, a bar, or a chip, or a cracker, any Little Debbie's or Hostess cupcakes, any kind of processed food, that's probably a food you don't want to eat. Reading from the journal, or from the book, Holland Fry Cancer Medicine, 6th edition, according to Dr. Raymond Rudden, quote, "The cell surface membrane plays an important role in the social behavior of cells, that is, communication with other cells, cell movement and migration, adherence to other cells, and recognition by the body's immune system." Unquote. The cell membrane is playing a key role in how cells talk to each other. See, cells are social beings. They live together. Think about it. You got 100 trillion little beings. And by beings, I mean little living entities that function and communicate and replicate and digest and have a life. Yes, a cell has a life. What's more, a cell is even conscious. There was a lie detector guy, I don't know what they call him, polygraph administrator, I suppose, famous one named Cleve Baxter. You may have heard of him. Wrote a book called The Secret Life of Plants. He also wrote a book called The Secret Life of Cells. Cleve took lie detector devices, electrodes, that are normally placed on people's arms to detect to see if they're lying, placed them on plants. And then he would talk about the plant, and he would cut the plant, and he would put water in the plant, or he'd put a toxic material in the plant, or he'd send love to the plant. He'd think good thoughts about the plant. He'd think bad thoughts about the plant. And everything he did, based on his lie detector reading, based on the electrodes that were stuck on the plant, everything he did, from thinking to cutting the plant to manipulating the plant some way, affected the plant's energy. The plant somehow knew when Cleve Baxter or his associates were thinking about it. And then Baxter decided to do the same thing for cells. He took human cells. He got subjects to take their, this is so cool, he's got subjects to take their cells out of their mouth, or out of their gums, scraped a little bit, and put it in a dish, and then put his little electrode devices on the dish or in the solution. And then he had his the owners of the cells communicate to the cells, and the cells responded. The cells are responsive. They're aware. They're conscious. They're intelligent. And this consciousness of the cell, this intelligence of the cell, is a key part of the of how the cell operates, and a key element of the health and well-being of a cell. Cells that are angry, or I should say sociopathic, they don't care about their neighbors, will grow out of control. A cancer cell is a sociopathic cell. Again, reading from Dr. Rudd, the cell surface membrane plays an important role in the social behavior of a cell. Cells are social. Cancer cells are sociopathic. They don't listen to their neighbors. They have somehow lost the ability to communicate. And remember, the communication is occurring at the cell membrane. Focus on the membrane, i.e. focus on the fats, the fatty nature. That's the most important thing that we can do to protect the cell membrane, is to focus on fats, dietary fats, and also, by the way, protecting fats. There's a vitamin that is poo-pooed by the medical model that only recently was actually really considered to be a required nutrient, and that's vitamin E. Vitamin E's main role in the body is to protect fats, especially the cell membrane. Vitamin E surrounds the cell membranes, especially in the skin, by the way. That's why vitamin E is so important for the skin. Not necessarily for anti-aging the skin, or for, well, not necessarily for helping the skin produce anything, but for protecting the cell membranes, especially from the sun. So cancer cells disease in general, these are largely membrane phenomena, particularly with cancer. This means that there's a major relationship between fats and cancer. So to prevent, in my opinion, the best thing we can do to prevent cancer or even to deal with it once you have it is pay close attention to the kinds of fats you're eating. Pay close attention to the kind of fats. If you're on chemotherapy or you're, God forbid, dealing with some kind of tumor or neoplasm or even cysts for that matter, avoid the bad fats as much as possible. If you've got a prostate problem, if you're worried about prostate cancer or you have benign BPH, benign prostatic hypertrophy, if you're dealing with any prostate issue, focus on the fats. Stay away from the bad ones. Make sure you're using the good ones. Stay away from the trans fats. Stay away from the interesterified fats. Stay away from the processed fats. Focus on the good ones. Interesterification is this, it's not really that new, actually. Interesterification is a chemical processing where liquid oils are turned into solid fats. Solid fats are prized in the world of food processing because they're so stable. Think of a rock. A rock is really stable. It just sits there. So in the world of baking, solid fats have a really interesting property. They can be liquefied by heat, and then they'll re-solidify. And when they're liquefied by heat, and then they re-solidify, and they're combined with starches, something very interesting happens. Starches have lots of spaces, lots of holes in them. Starches, of course, are like flour. So flour has, if you look at it under a microscope, you'll see lots of little holes in it. And when you combine flour with a fat that is liquid, the liquid fat will go in the holes. And then when that fat hardens, you get tiny little microscopic holes of starch filled with hardened fat. And for some reason, human beings find that combination unbelievably delicious. And this is what deep frying does. Deep frying, for example, potatoes, will take the liquid fat that is in the deep fryer, and it will fill in the little openings in the potato, and then you pull the French fry out, and as that liquid fat cools, it creates this unbelievably delicious snap, this taste and texture that human beings find unbelievably delicious. So food processors are always on the lookout and absolutely dependent for their products on liquid fats that turn solid or solid fats that melt into liquid. Look at it either way. And this is why Crisco is in such high demand. It's why lard, by the way, used to be in such high demand. It would do the same thing, but of course with much more expense. So interesterification, hydrogenation, all of these ways of taking liquid fats and creating trans fats, all of these food processing techniques are ways that food processors can create foods that human beings find unbelievably delicious. And if you're eating deep-fried foods or Little Debbie's or Twinkies or any kind of processed oils, rest assured, you are getting these trans fats, these interesterified fats, and you're doing a destructive, nasty number on your cell membranes, and it is a short jump to all chronic degenerative diseases from there. Use coconut oil. Use butter if you're going to cook. Coconut oil and butter are healthful fats that can create the same kind of effects as these processed fats. All right, I'm Pharmacist Ben, 844-236-6010 is our number. We'll be back after this. Okay, we are back on the bright side. Got lines open, 844-236-6010. If you have questions about anything we're speaking about here today or a health challenge you or a loved one may be dealing with, if you want to purchase any of the longevity products you hear advertised on the bright side, go to brightsideben.com, pharmacistben.com, or criticalhealthnews.com. It's brightsideben.com, pharmacistben.com, or criticalhealthnews.com, or call 866-735-2470, 866-735-2470 for more information. If you are in the Dearborn, Michigan area, I'll be doing a talk at the Cancer Prevention Convention, Stephanie McKeith's event. Cancer Prevention Convention 2018. That's this coming August 19th. That would be, a couple weeks, August 19th, 9 a.m. to 7:30 p.m. at the Dearborn Inn Marriott Hotel. That is 20301 Oakwood Boulevard in Dearborn, Michigan, zip code 48124. go to tickettaylor.com if you want to get tickets. I suppose you need tickets for that. And there'll be myself and 9 other health professionals talking about various subjects. I'll be talking a little bit about skin cancer and cancer in general. Some of the ideas we share here on The Bright Side. Cancer is a scourge that does not have to occur. So unfortunate. 80% of cancers are lifestyle-based, according to the Surgeon General of the United States, former Surgeon General of the United States, Edwin Koop. 80% of cancers are unnecessary, and there is no more hideous diagnosis than a human being can have, health diagnosis, than cancer, and 80% of it is based on how we live our lives. Anyway, that's Cancer Prevention Convention 2018, Sunday, August 19th at the Dearborn Inn in Dearborn, Michigan. I'll also be doing a talk at my lab this Saturday. If you're in the Denver area, we'll be doing skin and nutrition, be kind of informal. We'll just be talking generally about how you can help, how you can address skin health challenges using nutrition, both internal nutrition and topical nutrition, something I've been talking about for decades, the idea that you can use topical and internal nutrition. Well, the idea that you can use nutrition for the skin, that's kind of revolutionary, and there's still doctors who don't believe that's true. And then the idea of topical nutrition. So there's two key components to this idea of nutrition in the skin. One is that what you eat can affect your skin. I'm sure that sounds like common knowledge to everybody listening to this, but still most people aren't hip to that idea. And then secondly, the idea that there's topical nutrition that you can use that will support internal nutrition. That is so cool to me, is that there's this phenomena of where the skin will utilize certain nutrients that can be put on top of, not just the skin, but skin cells will utilize topical nutrients, vitamin C and vitamin A in particular, which is why I've said so many times, I'll say it again, if you're not using vitamin C and vitamin A in your skin anti-aging protocol, if your skin anti-aging products do not feature high concentrations of vitamin C and vitamin A, you are missing the boat on topical skincare, period. If you got a skincare company that is trying to sell you an anti-aging product that doesn't have super high concentrations of vitamin C and vitamin A in its correct form, they don't know what they're talking about. And you're wasting your money. And I don't care if it's Cindy Crawford who's selling it or some doctor from France who found a melon that only grows, that regenerates itself after it's been cut off or whatever that heck that melon is supposed to do. Vitamin C and vitamin A, when they're applied in the correct form and in the correct dose, topically, that is on top of the skin, will migrate down to the lower levels of the skin where the so-called viable cells, that is the living cells, are. From the surface of the skin, there's no living cells there. The living cells are down deep. And vitamin C and vitamin A, when it's applied to the dead cells on the surface, if it's in the correct form and the correct dose, will migrate past that dead layer, that dead cell layer, and get down to the viable cells, the living cells, where they will literally get taken into the cells like the cell is eating. You can almost see a fork and knife and spoon coming out on the cell membrane. That's basically what's happening. The cell is eating the vitamin C. The cell is eating the vitamin A. And the vitamin C and vitamin A are going into the cell, and not just into the cell, into the genetics, into the genes, where they turn on the production of proteins, and they stimulate growth and division. Everything you want in an anti-aging product or anti-aging ingredient, you get the true benchmark, the gold standard of anti-aging ingredients are vitamin C in the correct form, that is fatty vitamin C, and vitamin A in the correct form, that is retinol, or if you want to go the prescription route, retinoic acid. Where do you get them? Where do you get products with high concentrations of both of these major players in skin anti-aging? Truthtreatments.com, truthtreatments.com, our Truth Transdermal C Serum, Truth Transdermal C Balm, Truth Retinol 5% Gel, Truth Retinol 1% Gel, our Truth Omega-6 Healing Cream, and our Truth Cleansers, and now our Truth Connective Tissue Building Supplement, Truth Collagen Repair Complex, and soon our Truth Blemish Repair Complex are all designed to heal and grow skin, grow tissue. And that's how they work. All right, we'll be talking about that on this Saturday at 2240 Curtis Street, Denver, Colorado, zip 80205, 11 a.m. Hope to see you there. And time to hit the phones, 844-236-6010. Actually, let's do a couple quick stories here. And then we'll get your phone calls, which we don't have a whole bunch anyway. It's 844-236-6010. Eating high fiber foods reduces the effect of stress on gut and behavior. This is from the Journal of Physiology. Eating high-fiber foods may reduce the effects of stress on our gut, according to new research. Stress is a significant health concern and cause major changes in the gut and in the brain, which can cause changes in behavior. In recent years, there's been a growing interest in the link between gut bacteria and stress-related disorders, including anxiety, depression, and IBS. There's a major relationship between so-called psychological distress and mental disorders, including schizophrenia and autism, and the gut. You guys probably know this. If you're new to this program, you may not have heard this. Anything that you can do to support gut health will support mental health and psychological health. And this is what the study was about. Eating high fiber foods reduces the effect of anxiety and depression on the gut and on the digestive tract. Eating high fiber foods, of course, is basically vegetables. Those are your best high fiber foods. And one of the main reasons why this occurs, and this is something that we're going to talk about, probably, if not tomorrow, the next day, is the fact, this is so cool, that brain chemicals are released from fats by the action of gut bacteria. So you got gut bacteria, you've got fibers, and you've got brain chemicals. Gut bacteria chew the fiber, release the fats, and those fats function as brain chemicals, these special magical fats that we're going to be talking about in the next few days. That's so cool. Fiber, probiotics, bacteria plus fiber yields brain chemicals, so-called short-chain fatty acids. Super fascinating stuff. We'll talk about that in our coming days as we continue discussing fats and ways that you can take care of digestive health and mental health, prevent cancer, heart disease, pretty much all chronic long-term degenerative diseases, and slow down the aging process by the correct and strategic use of fats, dietary fats. All right, 844-236-6010. Let's go to Tony in California. Oh, there's the music, Tony. I'm going to put you back on hold, buddy. We'll get to Tony. Hang on, Tony. We'll get you when you come back from our break. Got lines open, 844-236-6010. You're listening to The Bright Side. I'm Pharmacist Ben. We will return right after this. Side 844-236-6010, and we do have lines open for you. 844-236-6010. Good morning, Tony in California. What's going on, buddy?
Good morning, Pharmacist Ben. This program you have today is the most information dense program I have ever heard by you.
Are you serious? I didn't realize that.
You hit the topics that you haven't emphasized before, like the communication between the cells. With that, but I also want to end with a question on a label of a can of salmon that I just opened up.
Okay.
And you never say much about canned foods. I guess they're processed, but the ingredients are only salmon and salt.
Yeah.
As it says, with the cholesterol it has, it's very clear. It's calcium 10% for only a quarter of a cup. So I'm wondering, am I eating good stuff?
Canned is pretty much the best kind of, I don't say best, but as far as processed foods go, it's the least processed of the foods. They don't add anything to it. If it's fish, I think
exactly.
I think they can them right on the ship, I think, don't they?
But
do you know anything about that?
The main reason I called is I missed the name of the oil you wanted me to put a half a teaspoon on some cucumbers.
Udo's Blend. It's a nutritional oil. It's called Udo's, U-D-O-S. Blend. And I talk about Udo's a lot. Udo Erasmus is we've had him on the program before. He's like a absolutely brilliant biochemist. And the reason I say that is because he loves the molecule.
Where do I get that?
A health food store. Any health food store.
Thanks.
Yeah.
I'm going to get off real fast, but
go ahead. I'm going to finish this about the Udo's blend. Cause I talk about it a lot. And the reason I talk about it a lot is because Udo Erasmus is an absolutely brilliant biochemist, number one. He wrote the Bible of Fats. If you want to, if you like this, all this stuff about fats, the Fat Bible is called Fats That Kill, Fats That Heal. It's in its like 10th or 12th or 20th edition. I first read it in the 1980s or actually the early 1990s, somewhere around there when I was big into bodybuilding. Bodybuilders really understand the importance of good fats, by the way. And it really just completely blew me away, all the complexity that's associated with this thing called fats, and I became a lover of fats ever since. And anyway, Udo is the fat expert, and he has an oil, a nutritional oil called Udo's Blend that's available as liquid. And even though I know, you know, you're not supposed to eat, well, you know my take on that probably. Some nutritionists will say you're not supposed to eat liquid oils. This thing is so densely packed with nutrition, and I have personally seen the benefits in terms of my patients, especially with skin, but other things too. It's just a densely packed nutritional supplement, oil nutritional supplement. He also has capsules, but I like the liquid. If you're going to go capsules, go Ultimate EFA. If you're going to go liquid, my personal philosophy is to go Udo's Blend, and it's delicious on cucumbers, and it's delicious on tomatoes, and you mix it with salt. It is unbelievable, especially on any kind of veggies, but also on eggs. I find it delicious on hard-boiled eggs. That's what I love. It turns your hard-boiled eggs into a delicious snack. Anyway, that's my story on Udo's Blend. I don't have anything to do. There's no financial gain in it for me, but I just am a big believer in the product. Anything else, Tony?
Sure. About 3 years ago, I gave you some ascorbyl palmitate.
Yeah, remember I gave you that cream?
It was a pill bottle. I gave it to you. We were sitting at the radio station.
Yeah. I remember that.
Okay. Is that the kind you want us to be using?
It's not as topically. You're talking about topically?
Well, yeah.
Yes, topically, that's the way you want to use it. But the problem, as I think I may have told you, ascorbyl palmitate is extremely difficult to work with. And there's a very interesting story behind it, and I don't want to digress too much, but nonetheless, I'll just cut to the chase and say my omega-6 healing cream represents my discovery of how to work with high concentrations of ascorbyl palmitate, and it makes, if you've used the omega-6 healing cream, you know it's a phenomenal product, and it's a very unique product. You've never felt anything like it before. You've used it, right, Tony?
Yeah.
You know how
I have used it.
You know, and I'm not kidding when I say it's a phenomenal product, right? I mean, for healing, it's just amazing, jaw-dropping for healing. But do you notice how weird it feels? How it has that rich, soft, kind of buttery texture to it that nothing else, no other products have?
I have about a half-hour conversation with you sometime. Maybe I'll do it on email about that, about the way it's affecting the thing I'm using it on my face. So, but I don't want to get into that now.
All right.
I just want to say that I discovered why I'm plateauing at 240 and can't get below that. I have cortisol problems, and I never knew about cortisol. How do you get rid of cortisol?
A lot of different ways, and everybody has cortisol problems, but it gets worse as you get older, and that will definitely cause you to plateau. Cortisol is a catabolic, a breakdown hormone, and it will definitely make building very difficult and it will accelerate aging. On all its levels. So here's the thing about cortisol. There's a psychological component, mental component, and there's a physical component.
That's right.
They're both. Yes. They're both. Yes. So when we think of stress, cortisol is known as stress hormone, of course. And when we think of stress, we often think of psychological stress, emotional stress, mental stresses, and those are very important, and they need to be recognized. And I don't talk about them a lot on this program, but I talk about a little bit, but I don't talk about them enough probably, because they are really powerful levels or powerful modalities for healing and for health and for wellness and also for disease. If you got to address those
problem components.
However, sugar can elevate cortisol. Inflammatory chemicals in the body can elevate cortisol. Cortisol itself can elevate cortisol. You get into a positive feedback loop where the cortisol causes a breakdown, which causes more cortisol, which causes more breakdown. So there's lots of physiologic reasons why, or physiologic causes for elevated cortisol that you can address. First thing to do is fast, in my opinion. The best thing to do is a quick fast. And that will help calm down cortisol in the sense that when you eat the wrong kinds of foods, your cortisol will jump. Cortisol, it will help the body handle the stresses of bad diets. So prolonged fasting may increase cortisol, but if short-term intermittent fasting will stabilize your cortisol. You can use nutrients like vitamin E and vitamin A and pregnenolone.
Yes.
Are you using pregnenolone?
No, I'm not.
Melatonin is another one.
I am going to fast. I have not been fasting. You recommend about a 3-day fast?
2 day, 3 day, 1 day, just throw it in, mix in a fast once a week or twice, once every couple weeks. You know,
once information, I'm going to have to say goodbye. Thank you.
Okay, buddy. Take care. It's good to talk to you. All right. David in California. Good morning. Welcome to the Bright Side.
Yeah, I'm a long time listener. I use your creams and all that. I recently had a mini stroke.
Okay. Want some help there?
Pardon me?
You want some help real quick? We only got a couple minutes, but let me give you some ideas.
I take a lot of the products, PTT and all that.
Okay, well, here, this is the theme, and then I'll tell you some supplements and some products, but here's the theme. You have to be very kind and loving to your body at this time. Do you understand what I'm saying?
I do.
You have to keep everything. It's like a child that's been wounded. If you had a kid, just think of a kid. God forbid, if you have a child who's sick in the hospital or had an accident or something. You love that kid. You nurture that kid. You're so kind and gentle to that kid. Well, that kid's your body.
Okay.
And that's so important. That's the theme. Now, the specifics of it are keep sugar out of your diet as best as possible. Sugar represents a major stressor on the body. Keep digestive toxicity and food allergens, anything that messes up your gut, out. Make sure you're getting fiber. In fact, use fiber every day to fill yourself up because food is not going to be your friend at this point, although nutrition is. The less food you eat and the more nutrients you get, and that means eating nutrient-dense, things like organ meats and fish and eggs and algae, and then nutritional yeast, olives, avocados, oysters, shellfish in general. Nutrient density is what you're looking for. Vegetables, of course, vegetable juices, anything nutrient dense, so you can get nutrition without having to get the calories. So when I say food is not your friend, what I really mean, calories are not your friend. And also, of course, the toxicity in the foods. Do probiotics and fermented foods every single day. Make sure you're using bone broth protein and chicken soup every day.
Okay.
And then stay on the Healthy Start Pack. If you want specific nutrients, vitamin C, I'd be taking extra vitamin C. Get a book called The Sinatra Solution.
And Sinatra Solution, okay.
Get a book, and he talks about magnesium, also vitamin C, I think he talks about, something called ribose, a few acetyl L-carnitine. That's another very important one. Carnitine in general is very important for cardiovascular health. I'd be taking extra magnesium. You can use the OsteoMag for that. But let's see what else real quick that I could tell you about.
What about for appetite in general? It just seems to have killed my appetite.
Don't worry. Don't eat. It's your body's wisdom. That's your body's wisdom. Eating's for kids, and it's kind of an indulgence at this point in your life. So, you know, I know that's sounds kind of weird. Nutrition, that you need. The last thing I was going to tell you about is make sure you're getting your essential fatty acids. Make sure you're taking 9 Ultimate EFAs a day. I take 12 or even 15. And then I would also throw in some Ultimate Selenium and also some Ultimate Niacin every day. All right, David, I got to motivate. I'm out of time.
I know you do. Thank you.
Thank you. God bless you. Good luck with everything. All right, that's all the time we have for today on The Bright Side. Thanks for listening. If you're in the Denver area, want to see you at my lab on Saturday. This Saturday, August 4th, we'll talk skin and nutrition. That's 2240 Curtis Street in Denver, Colorado. Have yourselves a wonderful, beautiful, awesome, spectacular day. I'm Pharmacist Ben. We will talk to y'all later. Bye for now.